Navigation transitions in SwiftUI are a game changer because they allow you to create smooth, custom animations when navigating between views, enhancing the user experience. With simple and intuitive code, you can add dynamic effects that make your app feel polished and engaging. In this tutorial, you'll learn step by step how to implement navigation transitions from the basics to more advanced techniques, ensuring that your app's navigation flows seamlessly, looks professional. Whether you're new to SwiftUI or looking to level up, this guide will show you exactly how to use the powerful feature of navigation transitions. And if you want to meet me on a Zoom call for 2 hours at the price of one, go ahead and check out the link in the description. Now, today we are going to talk about transitions, hero transitions, navigation transitions, whatever you'd like to call them. They are so amazing in iOS 18. Now, let me just show you what I have prepared for here. We have a simple demo project. And how do you navigate? Well, let's just create a new destination view. There we go, destination view. Let's just add a Swift file. So struct, let's import SwiftUI. So we're just going to recognize it. And then a struct of destination view, that's fine, and destination view. Now, on the content view, let me just remove all of this, and let's add a navigation link with, title key destination. Let's just use that one. And let's just use destination view, and then right over here as the destination view. Okay, we got our link. Now all we have to do is just enrobe the content view into a navigation stack. There we go. Nice navigation stack. So the navigation link would be readily available. So let's build and run and let's see how all of this looks like. There we go. Let's click on the navigation link. And it's just navigating, the usual stuff. Now I want to take this to the next level with navigation transition. So let's just prepare for that. First of all, let me just go back to the content view. And here you can see that I just added a simple, a string that is actually a text on the navigation link. I want to make this even better. I want this to be the source view with some colors and text. Let's just create that. So let's just right click over here, new empty file, and let's call this source view. There we go. Again, let's import SwiftUI. Let's have a struct, struct source view. And then let's just have this as a view. And then our body, there we go. Let's just have that. And instead of the text of source view, that's obvious. We are going to have some color, a color of teal. And let's have this as a frame width and height, let's just make it 200 by 200 so we can see it better. And let's have some clip shape. With a shape of a rect, with a corner radius of 25. Yeah, we're going to have some corner radiuses. This is how you would do it. And then let's just have some system image so we can see some, some labeling over there. I'm just going to put that as an overlay and image, system named, and then Swift is my choice over here. Let's have the font of large title and the foreground style. Foreground style. There we go. Dot white. Okay, so that would be our source view. Now let's take a look at our destination view. Let's just go right over here. First of all, I'm also going to remove that back button. I'll just show it to you right over here because the transition, the animation to transition to this destination view will be a different one. And this back button will just appear right over here. It will be clumsy. Therefore, I will need the dismiss environment so I can dismiss this view programmatically. So at environment, let's just have the dismiss private var dismiss. Okay, what do I need over here? Let's just use the same color and just push it all the way up. So it would need be a really nice transition. First of all, let's have that V stack. So I'm just going to have a spacer at the bottom of the V stack. And then right over here, I'm just going to have that color of teal. And let's just have a frame with a height, not infinity, I'm just going to have 200. And then again, the overlay of that image of system named Swift, and then font, large title, there we go. And then the foreground style. Every iOS developer can unlock tremendous growth with the help of a mentor. A mentor provides personalized guidance, industry insights, and practical solutions to help you navigate the complexities of the iOS ecosystem and fast-track your process. With tailored feedback and expert career advice, a mentor ensures you stay on the path to success. At Rebeloper, I offer one-on-one mentorships designed to sharpen your skills and help you achieve your full potential. Ready to take your next step? Visit rebeloper.com/mentoring and start your journey today. So what else do we need? Well, this color will be, you know, all the way on top. I wanted to ignore the safe areas, so I'm going to do that on the whole vertical stack. So ignore safe area, and then let's hide that bar back button. So navigation bar back button hidden. It's at this one. And also let's add that, close button, the dismiss button as a toolbar item. So toolbar with a content and then toolbar item. Placement, let's just have that on the top right corner on iOS. So that would be our primary action. And then on the content, a simple button, a button with an action and label. The action will be dismiss, you know, we're using the environment that we just created. And then on the label, let's just have an X button, an X circle, X mark. So image, again with the system name, and then X mark, let me type this out correctly, circle and then fill. Okay, so that's fine. Font of title will be just fine. And then foreground style, not red, you know, we could just use red, but let's just use thin material. So we're going to have that nice effect. Okay, that's our destination view. We have our source view, we have our destination view. Now it's time to, first of all, let me double check. We do have the navigation stack, so we can actually on the content view create our new navigation link. I'm going to remove this because we do need a label. So navigation link with a destination and label. So this is what we are going to use. And what do we add over here? Well, destination view right over here. And for the label, we are going to have our source view. Okay, so let's just build and run and see if this actually worked. And then we are going to add the navigation transition in just a second. So clicking over there, yeah, that's fine. X button tapped. There we go. Really nice. Okay. Of course, this is not what we want. This is just regular, you know, automatic transition. What we want is a zoom out transition. So first of all, we need to create a namespace. The namespace is going to link the two views together. You will see in just a second inside the code. So at namespace var, let's just make it private var, let's just call this namespace. Of course you may name it, if you are using multiple ones, name it accordingly. Okay, so first of all, let's add that namespace, let's link it to a navigation transition. So on the navigation view, yeah, it's also already suggesting, but I don't want the one with just the zoom. I want it also to link it to the namespace. So I'm just going to type it out and let's see, auto completion, navigation transition. There we go. With a style. Let's use that dot zoom, and the source ID will be kind of a string. It has to be a hashable. This is kind of your ID for the source, and then you are just going to say, okay, from this source, navigate over here. So I'm just going to have this as zoom, whatever you'd like. It has to be unique if you are using multiple ones. And then the namespace. So namespace right over there. So this is how we kind of label the destination view. And now on the source view, we need to say, okay, this is where we are coming from to the navigation destination with the navigation transition. So we are going to use the matched transition source. So matched transition source with an ID, and the namespace AI already suggests that this should be it. And indeed, we have a zoom ID and the namespace as the namespace ID. Okay, let's just see this because, you know, we just prepared it and these are the two things that we need to set up. Let's just click on there. Really, really nice. Now you saw that this X button right over here, it just popped. It's because of the navigation toolbar item. If you want it outside, you know, just appear instantly, you don't want to put it in the navigation toolbar. The same would be, you know, with the back button. It would just pop over there, which is kind of ugly. This one, I prefer it. It's fine. This is how it looks like. It's really, really amazing. Okay, and that is how you are going to use navigation transition. Now, if you like these type of tutorials and how I teach things, go ahead and check out my offer for mentorings. If you are going to buy one, you are going to get two. Basically, you buy 1 hour and you are going to get 2 hours of mentoring. The link is down in the description.